Today, we're going to learn the fastest technique for flambient photography, all with the power of Affinity Photo. For those of you that don't know, flambient photography is a common technique used in real estate, where a photo taken with ambient light is combined with a photo taken with a flash on. Flash plus ambient equals flambient. To make a flambient photo, you first need to take two pictures of the room. This is best done while using a tripod to make sure the photos are in the same position. Then you can open the raw images in Affinity Photo and edit them from the develop persona. We won't be covering the develop persona in this video, but if you're interested in learning more about it, we have an entire chapter dedicated to this persona in our Beginner's Guide to Affinity Photo, which you can check out in the video description. After you're done editing the images in the develop persona, press develop and then export them as JPEGs. For this video, I've put download links in the video description for the raw versions of both images, as well as their exported JPEGs, so that you can jump right into this point of the flambient process. To begin editing our flambient photo, we need to bring the two exported JPEGs into Affinity Photo and make sure they're lined up with each other. To do this, we can use Affinity's Stack feature. Just come to File, and then down to New Stack. Then add the two images. Then press OK. Now the two images are perfectly lined up with each other. Even if you used a tripod, I still recommend you put both images into a stack, because a tripod can sometimes shake a little while you're taking a photo. After stacking photos, Affinity puts them inside of a group. To ungroup them, just right-click on the layer and press Ungroup. Then put the ambient layer on top of the flash layer. Next, come to the Channels panel. From here, we can see that our entire photo is made of red, green, and blue color channels. We're going to use the red channel to make a selection. To do this, right-click on the channel's name, and then press Load to Pixel Selection. Now we have a selection of the brightest parts of the red channel. We're going to use this selection to mask our ambient layer. Just make sure you have the ambient layer selected, and then press on the mask icon. Then press Command or Control D to deselect. The mask we applied made it so only the parts we had selected remain visible. This is the exact opposite of what we want. We want to hide the bright parts of this layer. To do this, select the mask and invert it by pressing Command or Control I. Now the bright parts of the ambient layer have been hidden. To learn more about masks, be sure to check out our Beginner's Guide to Affinity Photo in the video description. Now we'll select the ambient layer and change its blend mode to luminosity so it's only affecting the brightness of our image, not the colors. Now we can continue to refine our mask by painting black on any parts of the ambient layer that we don't want shown, thus making the flash layer visible in those parts of the image. But first, we need to decide which parts of the flash layer we like better than the ambient layer. To do this, turn the ambient layer off and on and compare it to the flash layer. Which parts of the flash layer do you like more? Personally, I prefer the way the floor by the door looks on the flash layer. Let's turn the ambient layer back on and select its mask. Then we can paint in black to hide the ambient layer's floor. Press B for the paintbrush tool and make sure your color is set to black. Also, set your hardness to 0%. Then you can begin painting. You can quickly change the size of your paintbrush while painting by using the bracket keys underneath the equal sign on your keyboard. You can also paint in white if you ever mask out too much of the layer on accident. To switch your colors, just press X. Our basic flambient effect is now done. We're still going to do some more enhancements to the photo, but let's stop here to see a before and after. I'll turn the ambient layer off so we can see the original flash image. And here it is with the flambient effect applied. As you can see, our image already looks a lot better, but with a little more editing, we can improve it even more. Let's make the photo brighter by applying a brightness and contrast adjustment. Bring up the brightness as well as the contrast. The problem with this adjustment is that it's making everything brighter, including the bright lights by the TV. We want most of the photo brighter, but we don't want to make the lights in the room too bright. To fix this, have the adjustment layer selected, and then press on this gear icon. This brings up our blend ranges. We won't dive deep into blend ranges right now, because all we need to do is bring the last circle all the way down. This makes it so our adjustment layer is not applied to the brightest parts of the photo, which is exactly what we want. Now, this adjustment is adding a nice boost to the lighting of our photo. We could also add extra brightness to specific parts of the photo. To do this, make another brightness and contrast adjustment layer and bring up the brightness to around 30%. Then, invert the adjustment by pressing Command or Control I. Now, the adjustment is being applied to nothing. But we can use the paintbrush to paint this adjustment onto any parts of the photo we want. Just paint with a white paint, and make sure your hardness is set to 0% and your flow is around 10%. Having your flow at 10% allows you to slowly paint the adjustment layer onto the areas you want. To make our brushstrokes less noticeable, we can come to our filters and then apply a Gaussian blur filter to the brightness and contrast layer. This will blur the edges of the areas we painted on. As you can see, this adjustment has really helped to brighten the parts of the photo we painted on. Finally, let's enhance the colors in our image. To do this, apply a vibrance adjustment layer, and then increase the vibrance quite a ways. Then paint in black on the parts of the photo that have become too saturated. To see a final before and after, we'll turn all of the layers off except for the original photo that had the flash on. Here's what we started with, and here's our completed image. Thanks for watching, my friends, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.